If you are new to the channel, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. We are moving right along with our coderprise Laravel Breeze project, and today I want to work on setting up a toggle button so that we can toggle light mode and dark mode. If we head over to the project and we take a look at the resources, views, layouts, app.blade.php, we want it somewhere in our navigation. Now our navigation, it's actually sitting in the same folder, but it is in the navigation.blade.php, which is right here. If we scroll down a little bit, we can take a look and see about where we want to put this. Now I actually want to put it next to that settings dropdown. So for now, I'll just put toggle button just so that we can see something. And then we can decide how we want to style this. Okay, so it's right up here, which means we should probably do a div and a little flexing in order to make this line up. I'll get rid of this, and then I will shrink this down a bit. And then we can do, I'll just wrap this so that we have a div around the hamburger and that drop down button that's already there. And then we'll do class is, we'll say flex. And then we'll do item center so that we can drop it down. Perfect. That's exactly where we want it. Now, in one of the videos, I mentioned that I was missing some of the components for this download file that I have for you guys. And I have managed to add all of the rest of the components, which includes the file input component, all the custom ones that we made, the file input, the text area input, and now it also has the theme switcher. The link to this from my Google Drive will be in this description of this video. I won't change the old videos just yet, but for now, this is going to be the new one. It's coderprise assets, but it's called coderprise assets 2, and it's a zip file. And you'll have access to that from the links in the description and below as a pinned comment. So what I want to do is I want to grab our theme switcher here. And I got this styling from somewhere online. I genuinely can't remember where, so I can't really put it in the list of attributes. But whoever did it, you know, thanks. So for now, I am going to go ahead and paste it where we have that toggle button. And all it is really two icons. It's a button, a clickable button, and it's got two different icons. This is all Tailwind styling, and it also has dark mode in the classes for it. And there are two icons in here. One is, I think it's the sun, and one is the moon. So let's go and see what this looks like. Okay, there it is. And it doesn't actually do anything yet, but that's essentially what it looks like. Now, before we do this, we have actually manually created our components and added them to here. But Laravel also has a helper function that we can use the command line for. And this will be artisan make component. And because we have it in a folder, it's a custom folder, we can say custom dot, what do we call it? We'll call it theme switcher. And doing this will create the component, but it will also create another folder up here for app view, and it will add it in here. And we don't actually need that. We just need the file. So here we can say dash dash view, and hopefully that should work. Our component was created successfully. Let's go and take a look, and here it is. And so now we have a new component, and we didn't create any extra folders or anything because we just needed a very simple and basic component to hold our theme switcher. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to grab this. And then I'm going to go ahead and put it in our new theme switcher file here. Which means that in here now, we can just do X custom theme switcher. Let me close this off so we can show it. And now you can see if you hover, you can see the resource for this. And this is just one of my extensions allowing us to see that. So let's go and make sure that we can still see this toggle button that we have. Make sure I refresh just to be sure. And it is still here. Let's go ahead and add some functionality. So how's all of this going to work? Well, like I said in the previous videos, we have Alpine.js, and Alpine.js just allows us to do small little types of functionality. For something like this, it actually works pretty good. So what I want to do is I want to go to the app.blade.php first, and we need to initialize Alpine.js with some data, and this will allow us to also deal with local storage. So on this body class here, I am going to initialize it first. We're going to open this up, and that's all that this is. This xData is just initializing Alpine.js. But before we do that, I'm just going to go ahead and slide this over so that we can see a few things in here. And the first thing that I want to do is I want to create a property called dark mode. And this dark mode will just have a boolean on it. For this, we want to grab our local storage, get item, dark. And then if we have that from local storage, then dark mode will equal true. So I'm missing something in here and I need in quotations here. And then we want to initialize something. We want to initialize an Alpine function, which is just watch. If you've used view before, then you kind of have an idea of what watch is. And it's basically just watching the browser just to see if there's anything being changed. So we'll initialize it. And here will be $watch dark mode, because we want to look at this data property. We want to keep an eye on it. And then we'll say value equals local storage set item. Not look right. Dark equals the value. If in our local storage, the value is set to dark, there is dark set in the item, then that dark will be the value. Let's bind some classes on here. Say that dark will equal dark mode. Because Tailwind has dark mode, we're just tapping into our Tailwind classes. That's all this is doing. So this dark mode is actually going to come from our Tailwind config. In order to instantiate dark mode, we need to put in our Tailwind config file. We need to let it know. So we'll say dark mode equals class. And this is coming right from the Tailwind documentation. Now that we have it initialized on our body class, we should be able to start using it within our theme switcher. Now, all we need to do here is, because it's a button, we can put a click event listener on it, and we'll say add click equals dark mode equals not dark mode. And this is where we get the toggling from. So let's go into the browser and see if this actually works yet. Refresh it. Let's go ahead and click it. Look at that. Light mode, dark mode. If we refresh it, what's going on here? Let's open up the inspection tools so we can see in our location, local storage, we have dark mode is true. So then why is this set to light mode? Well, we have dark mode is true in our local storage. And if we refresh it, we're still not seeing it. So let's go and make sure that I didn't mess up some of the X data. Okay, well, it looks like this needs to be in single parentheses. And if we look through anything else, it should be fine. Let's try this again. We still have dark mode. So if I go ahead and change it to light mode, refresh, still in light mode, dark mode equals false. We'll go ahead and change it again. And dark mode is true. Make sure if we refresh, that's all good. Okay, very good. So we have a working toggle, but let's change it to dark mode. Let's try and go to some other pages. Look at that. There's some weird little flash. Even though it's changing, all right, it's got that weird flash. And that's basically because we're using JavaScript on our page. It has that weird little sort of glitchiness. Luckily, that's a really easy fix. And you might have seen something like this if you use Vue. Sometimes you need to have this X cloak on here, or in Vue, it would be V cloak. But Tailwind also has this as part of its little thing. So all we need to do is just really define this. So we'll go to the app.css and we'll just say that X cloak is display none. And that should now work. Let's try it in the browser. We'll go ahead and refresh just to make sure. Let's go to our vehicles. Now you see we don't have any more of that dark screen mode in here, which is very good. If we go to the create, then we also have dark mode in here. All that stuff's in here. So as you can see, my awesome, awesome styling is on here as well. Just a quick note about this dark mode. When we built the project, when I first initialized the project, I whipped up the project. I made sure to include dark mode so that all of the Tailwind classes are in here. And that's all this is. When you see dark, e.g. gray 800, that means that when it's in dark mode, then we get that color. And so that's just basically baked throughout all our default pages. So if you're adding pages, you just want to make sure that anything that you want to be triggered by dark mode, that you have that already set up. If you're enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button, as it really does help out the channel. Here's a video YouTube thinks you'll like, and here's a playlist to follow along. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.